أبناء الأعزاء، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. نكمل مع بعض الفصل الثالث، و describing data and numerical measures. نشوف دلوقتي إزاي نحسب الـ variance and standard deviation، مرة الـ population مرة الـ sample. الفورمولا بتاعت الـ population variance equals sigma squared sum x minus mu squared divided by n capital. الـ standard deviation هنا عارفين طبعا هو root، فيبقى اسمه sigma root sum x minus mu squared divided by n capital. هنحسبه من السامبل، بنسميه اس سكوير، يبقى الفيريانس اوف السامبل اس سكوير يكون سام اكس ماينس اكس بار سكوير ديفايد باي ان ماينس 1. انذر فورمولا سام اكس سكوير ماينس سام اكس 1 سكوير اوفر ان اول اوفر ان ماينس 1، اور ذا سيم فورمولا اس سكوير يكون سام اكس سكوير ماينس ان اكس بار سكوير ديفايد باي ان ماينس 1. لو خدت روت لاي واحده من دول هيديني الستاندرد ديفيجن. الثري فورمولاز لازم تعرفهم. معايا هنا population consists of 5 observations 3 3 4 7 and 8 determines the mean of the population and the variance and the standard deviation. هحط الداتا بتاعتي في سول كولوم، الاكس بتاعتي 3 3 4 7 8، التوتال بتاعي سم اكس ايكوال 5، ميو ايكوال سم اكس اوفر ان كابيتال ايكوال 5، ذا فيرست اوبزرفيشن ماينس ميو، سكند اوبزرفيشن ماينس يو، ثيرد اوبزرفيشن ماينس يو، اند فورث اوبزرفيشن ماينس ميو، فيرست اوبزرفيشن ماينس ميو. The value is must equal 0, x minus mu squared, sum x minus mu squared equals 22, mu equals sum x over n capital equals 5, sigma squared sum x minus mu squared over n, 4.5, the standard deviation is 4.5. Another example, the hourly wages for the sample of persons are 2, 10, 6, 8, and 9, calculate the variance and the standard deviation. The values is x, 2, 10, 6, 8, and 9, sum x equals 25, sum x divided by n equals the arithmetic mean x bar, which will be 7, x minus x bar, 2 minus 7, 10 minus 7, 6 minus 7, and so on. Sum x minus x bar must equal 0, x minus x bar squared equals 40. Sum x minus x bar squared equals 40. S squared sum x minus x bar squared over n minus 1 equals 10. S, the standard deviation of the sample, equals root 10, 3.16. The other formula, then I need to calculate x squared. The second column is x squared, as you see. The second formula, sum x squared minus sum x whole squared over n minus 1. Sum x squared 285. Sum x 35 power 2 divided by 5 all over 5 minus 1. The final value will be 10. The standard deviation will be root 10. The coefficient of variation can be used to compare between two or more data sets. The first value to compare to calculate the coefficient of variation is CV, S over X bar times 100. The second formula is Q3 minus Q1 divided by Q3 plus Q1 times 100. A study of weight and the price of two commodities. The weight is measured in kilograms and the price in pounds. The following information is available. X bar 120, X bar 2 equals 160, S1 5, S2 squared 64. Compare the variability, compare the dispersion of the weights and the price. For the first phenomena, CV1 equals S1 over X bar 1 will be 25%. The second phenomena, S2 over X bar 2 times 100, 8 over 160 times 100 equals 5%. The first coefficient of variation 25, the second is 5. According to the value of the CV, we can determine the type or the manner of the data. As the CV is close to zero, this is indicated that the data is more symmetric. Far from zero, this indicated that the data is less symmetric. A sample of 5 students has been selected randomly. The height in centimeters and the weight in kilograms have been observed as follows. The heights and the weights. Compare these two data sets. Firstly, we are dealing with the heights, x minus x bar, x minus x bar squared to calculate the standard deviation of heights. The standard deviation of heights will be 15.18, the arithmetic mean of heights 180, then the CV for heights is 8.8%. Same for the weights. The weights is y, sum y equals 375, y squared 29,203, y bar equals 75, standard deviation of y equals 16.42, CV for weights is 21.9, then the weights are more dispersion than their heights. The following data represents two variables, x and y. Compare the variability of the two variables. We note that 1000 is extreme value. We cannot apply the formula S over x bar times 100. We can apply the quartiles Q3 minus Q1 divided by Q3 plus Q1 times 100. First, sort the data in ascending order. Q1 location is the third. The value is 135. Q3 location is the ninth. The value is 195. The CV equals Q3 minus Q1 divided by Q3 plus Q1 times 100, 11.14. For the second variable, the data in ascending order. The first quartile location is 3, which is 42. The third quartile location is 9, which is 50. Then CV for the second phenomena is Q3 minus Q1 divided by Q3 plus Q1 times 100, 8.7%. The variable Y is less dispersion than the variable X. The shape of distribution. We can calculate the coefficient of skewness to show that the distribution is normal, as in the figure in the middle, or left skewed or right skewed. In the middle, symmetric distribution, the mean equals the median equals the mode, the three measures are equal. في الشيبل في right hand side, the mean greater than the median greater than the mode, then the long tail in the right hand side. In the left, the left hand, the long tail in the left hand side, the mean smaller than the median smaller than the mode. We have three formulas to calculate the coefficient of skewness. Sk equals 3 times x bar minus mu divided by s, or x bar minus mu divided by s. From these two formulas, we can calculate that the 3 x bar minus mu equals x bar minus mu. The quartile coefficient of skewness is Qsk, Q3 minus Q1 minus Q2 minus Q1 divided by Q3 minus Q1. For a practical distribution of wages, the mean equals 25, the median equals 25, the mode equals 25. And the ZSD, the standard deviation, is 1. Determine the coefficient of skewness. Since the mean equals the median equals the mode, then the coefficient of skewness equals 0. This distribution is symmetric. For a group of persons, the mean salary of is 542 and the median is 400. The standard deviation is 448.5. Calculate the coefficient of skewness. We can use this formula. 3x bar minus median over s equals 3 times 542 minus 400. Divided by 448.5.95. This is positive value, then the distribution is positive skewed, or the long tail in the right hand side. Calculate the quartile coefficient of skewness of the following data set. Firstly, sort the data from smallest to largest. The number of observations is 28 observations. Find the Q1 location, which is 7.25. Calculate the value of Q1, Q1 will be 214. Q2 location, n plus 1 divided by 2. The value of Q2 is 252. Q3 location is 21.75. The value is 304.25. The quartile coefficient of skewness, Q3 minus Q2 minus Q2 minus Q1 divided by Q3 minus Q1 equals 0.136, which is positive. Then the long tail in the right hand side. Thus, part is the chapter. We need to calculate the mean and the standard deviation and the variance for the group data frequency distribution. The arithmetic mean of the frequency distribution x bar equals sum fm divided by n. F is the frequency, m is the class midpoint, the upper limit plus lower limit divided by 2 for each class midpoint. The monthly quantity of an item in tons moved by a small IR line are tabulated below. Four up to six, six up to eight, eight up to 10, 10 up to 12, 12 up to 14, 14 up to 16. The frequencies is 2, 9, 8, 20, 11, and 5. We need to calculate the arithmetic mean. The first column contains the classes, lower limit and upper limit for each. The frequencies is the second. Sum f equals 55, which is n. The class midpoint, m, 4 plus 6 divided by 2, 6 plus 8 divided by 2, 10 plus 8 divided by 2, 10 plus 12 divided by 2. 12 plus 14 divided by 2. Fm, 2 times 5, 9 times 7, 8 times 9, 20 times 11, 11 times 13. Sum Fm, 508. X bar equals sum Fm divided by n equals 9.24. the standard deviation and the variance for the group data, S squared is the variance, sum F, brackets M minus X bar squared divided by N minus 1. The standard deviation is the same formula under the square root. Refer to the following frequency distribution, complete the variance and the standard deviation. The first class from 0 up to 6, 6 up to 12, 12 up to 18, and so on. The last class is 24 up to 30. The frequency corresponding frequencies 2, 4, 9, 6, and 3. The first column from the left contains classes, frequencies, class midpoint, Fm, m minus x bar, m minus x bar squared, f times m minus x bar squared. Then, n or sum f equals 24, sum fm 384, sum fm minus x bar squared 1056. Use the formula sum f times m minus x bar squared over n under the square root, the s will be 6.7759. The following table shows the grades of the mathematics and statistics for 100 students selected random. Take care from this example, my student. Mathematics grade 6 up to 8, 8 up to 10, 10 up to 12, 12 up to 14, 14 up to 16, 18, 16 up to 18, 18 up to 20. The corresponding frequencies 5, 9, 13, 16, 32, 21, and 4. The second frequency distribution, the statistics grades 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, and 20. The difference between these two distributions. The first distribution for mathematics, this one is frequency distribution. 6 up to 8, these classes, we need to calculate m, 6 plus 8 divided by 2, 8 plus 10 divided by 2, 10 plus 12 divided by 2, 12 plus 14 divided by 2, 14 plus 16 divided by 2, 16 plus 18 divided by 2, 18 plus 20 divided by 2. Then you need to calculate m for the mathematics. For the statistics, the m is pre-calculated. He gave me the m, m1, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, and 20. We don't need for the statistics to calculate the arithmetic mean. For the solution, firstly, we need to solve to find S over X bar, the coefficient of variation for mathematics. According to the result in this table, the arithmetic mean of mathematics is 13.8 and the standard deviation is 3.033. The CV for mathematics is 21.96%. The statistics, note that the first column is frequencies and the second column given M. We don't have the column for classes. Complete the table as you see. The coefficient of variation for mathematics is 20.17%. From these results, we can say that the statistics is less dispersion than the mathematics. This is the test bank. We have 25 questions. You need to calculate, solve these problems.